Hey, John, what's the diameter of that hole?
This hole is 13.6 millimeters.
Got it, thanks. And how do you know?
Well, this machine is accurate within 35 microns, so it has to be within that value, within that uncertainty.
Got it. And how do you know the accuracy is right?
So we measured a known identity across the entire table 25 times. If that passes within the 35 microns, we've proven that accuracy.
Ah. And how do you know that's right?
The artifact is calibrated to the ISO standard.
All right, cool. And how do you know that's accurate?
Are you still here?
A measurement is just a number, unless that number reliably means the same thing to everybody. That's why we have standards. And how do we follow these standards? Let's start with a definition. In metrology, a standard is the basis for a unit of measurement. It's the thing you refer back to when you need to ask stuff like, wait, how heavy is a pound again? These reference points are maintained by organizations like NIST in the US, CNOM in Mexico, the NRC in Canada, the NPL in the UK, the PTB in Germany, and the BIPM internationally. The references themselves can be published standards or physical ones. The way we actually stick to standards like these is through calibration. We compare our own measurements and measuring tools against a reference with a known accuracy to see how close we are. Calibrating regularly, and thus routinely staying in line with standards, helps us maintain consistency in our measurements. So, cool, we calibrate all our stuff on the rig, it checks out, great. But then how do we calibrate the tools we use for calibration? If a standard is the master reference for what a unit actually is, there can't be a bunch of copies of it because there might be slight differences between them. Plus, it wouldn't be the one master reference anymore. But we also can't just fly to NIST every time we want to check that our measurements are good. Thus, we use a series of comparisons between the official standard and our measurement tools. The catch? The more comparisons we get away from that standard, the less measurement certainty we have. So if you want any confidence in your measurements, it's crucial to have a chain of traceability from your measurement tool all the way back to the standard it's supposed to match. In other words, it means knowing exactly how every aspect of your measuring process relates back to official standards. Say you want to measure a thing. You measure that thing with the appropriate tool for the job, and now you have a number. Over time, to make sure the numbers you're getting are right, you calibrate that tool using a more accurate tool. That tool's accuracy is, in turn, ensured by calibrating with an even more accurate tool. And this super careful, increasingly tight accuracy test eventually leads back to the real deal, which is a dumb way of saying the standard. And traceability doesn't have to be linear like this either. As long as each element in your measuring process can still be clearly linked to the real deal, again, dumb thing to call a standard, then you should be good to go. For a specific example, let's look at this CMM. It's in a lab that is accredited to the ISO 17025 standard for use in extremely high accuracy measurements, within 0.3 micrometers, or about 12 millionths of an inch. So just the operation of the machine itself is tied straight to a standard. The machine's accuracy is maintained by calibrating to a step gauge. The step gauge, in turn, is calibrated by an internationally accredited agency who uses the ISO 10360 standard. Thus, every single aspect of the CMM's measurement process, from its functionality to its users, can be traced back to a standard with trust and confidence every step of the way. Maintaining standards is a key component of metrology. No matter what industry you work in, you need to trust that your measurements are what they say they are. Expert metrologists can help with this, and luckily, we might know some folks.